Keep your eyes open. This is only a car, not a tank, Corporal. Did you hear me? Keep your eyes on the road.
It's a rough road, sir.
Nonsense. If you keep your eyes on it instead of watching the sky. Nothing dangerous. And you, you idiot, you're asking for trouble, behaving like a coward. Your superior is the one who'll tell you to take cover. Your superior.
He saw an enemy plane. That's enough for me.
Whatever you say.
Ivan, I told the corporal to keep his eyes open. And a good thing. Our life is all too short. Corporal Mueller.
Davo.
Take it easy. And you'll earn my appreciation by staying alert. Let's go.
Davo.
Are as thick as mules. You idiot! Are you going to move that thing over, or do I have to clear the road with my pistol?
Give me a hand with the lieutenant.
This one weighs a ton. But it was all that good living.
Victor, get back up on the wagon. We'll cover them up.
Photographs. You better be on your way. Best of luck.
Let's go.
Hurry. There's no time to lose.
Come
it away.
You're passing business.
Come now, you forget.
What do you mean, forget?
First of all, present yourself in the correct manner to officers of the German army.
Feldwebel Hans-Sindler, I'm at your service, Oberleutnant.
Very well. What do you want?
Headquarters told me that there was a report of several gunshots in the vicinity. I was only investigating, and I thought...
You mean to say that for this you halted a couple of officers, eh? Extraordinary. I have patience, but you've strained my patience to the limit. I should report you. Now move.
Jawohl, Herr Oberleutnant, zu Befehl. Schnell, aufsetzen!
Drive on, Müller. You've lost too much time already. Hey, Professor. German officer never looks back.
Bother that rule. My back's a big target if they were to fire.
We got too much to do to lose you now.
But you're assuming, aren't you, that we'll make it to this unholy Zaire? Before you did all right. Now the tough part's ahead.
Now, you wouldn't want things to be too easy, would you, Professor? But I agree with you. I wish us all well.
Your documents, please. But these are my orders, sir. We are ready to move. We've been waiting for you since we received orders from our Office of Security to accompany you to Zaire. Superfels. Open!
You see, Professor, the Germans themselves will lead us to Zaire. All those months, planning and worrying and wondering how we were going to get in, and the way it worked out, it couldn't be easy.
Then, how to find the exit.
This way, Major.
And open. Major.
All close behind.
Mines?
Mines is hardly the word. Do you know what it's called by the field marshal? You may not believe it, but he calls it the devil's garden. Not even a cat could slip through without blowing itself to hell.
Ah, yes. We have one of your old students here, Major. All he talks about is the theories of the great Professor Dreyer. His name is Captain Mahler. He'll be delighted to see you. Follow me, please. Colonel Spidle, may I present Major Dreyer?
It's a pleasure, Dreyer.
Delighted to meet you.
And Oberleutnant von Getz.
A name I know well, von Getz. Your father, isn't he Lieutenant General von Getz?
Yes, sir.
I knew there was a resemblance. We fought side by side in Greece, young man. And as boys, we fought over your mother. He won.
Yes, sir.
Would you prefer, Professor, to rest a little bit? It has been a long journey. Then later, you can inspect the plant.
With your permission, Colonel, if the Major isn't too tired, I think that Mahler is quite anxious to show you his work.
And I am not the least bit tired, Colonel.
Thank you, sir. Then we can go have a look now.
Excellent. It's through this door here. I'll come with you.
Accompany the corporal to the enlisted men's quarters. You're not coming, von Getz?
Of course. I wouldn't miss it.
Come with me. Major Dreyer, may I present to you our young technical genius, Captain Mahler. He has designed and directed our project here at Zaire. I think you have every right to be proud of him. After all, he was your student.
I know I haven't had the pleasure of meeting you before, Professor, but I've always followed your work in your books and scientific papers. In this respect, I consider myself your student. May I say how honored I am to meet you this first time? If I've learned anything, Major, you've done it. I hope that you won't be too disappointed in what I've done in Normandy.
Oh, I'm sure it's marvelous, young Mahler. And I wish to say that I consider you an exemplary student.
You are too kind to me, Professor.
Mahler! Mind your own business, will you, and hold your compliments till later. As you'll see here, Professor, it's their funeral.
Have a look, sir.
Not a bad job, is it? You might say we're planning a warm reception for the Americans should they try to land here. Take a look, von Getz.
Congratulations, Mahler.
Thank you, sir.
Much impressed. You're quite right, Colonel Spidle. If the Allies try to land here, they haven't got a chance.
and make a quicker nap, Captain. Fritz really took a beating.
He sure did, Doss. But nobody was shooting back.
Keep me covered, you guys. I'm not through with this one yet.
Still.
Damn Nazi.
That's enough, Sergeant Dutch. Knock it off. Go find some other way to amuse yourself. You're too old to play with dolls.
Yes, sir.
That's it, Major.
That's not it. You've got just 10 seconds to clear that minefield. If you don't chop your time down, they'll get every one of you.
Major, we've made this dummy run 8 times and haven't been under 15 seconds yet.
Lower it.
How many of us do you figure those Germans will get per second?
Too many. The idea is to hold your casualty rate as low as possible.
Fall in!
Are you positive that this
is
an exact duplicate of the original?
Sure, it's an exact duplicate. All the bunkers on that coast are alike. They've been photographed more often than Rita Hayworth.
Look, Major, we're wasting a hell of a lot of time putting those pipes together. We better figure out some other way.
I don't care how you do it. Listen to me, Jack. That bunker is there and it's got to be taken, see? Cut it to 10 seconds or you'll get it in the neck. That's an order, Captain.
Yes, sir. All right, men, fall in. You heard the Major. One more time.
You heard Captain Murphy.
You men, this is an arrest camp. Report to Captain Murphy immediately.
All right, you guys, shake a leg out of the truck. Move it.
Heard about it? The alarm will be circulated tonight. Tomorrow, D-Day begins. And day after tomorrow, God willing, we land.
Yeah, God willing.
And Omaha Beach? The Devil's Fountains?
No news yet, I'm afraid.
Who's on the job?
An officer named Strobel. I'd say he's one of our most capable intelligence men. And two Frenchmen.
Strobel? Do I know him?
I'm sure you've heard of him. For quite a number of years before the war, he was a well-known actor on Broadway. You might say he was sort of the darling of Broadway.
I'd prefer to have a professional for this show. An actor.
Don't run him down. I think a hell of a lot of him. He'll do his best. It's about all we can go on. That he will do his damnedest.
Please join me in one more. Close it. Close it.
The fountain is having a full test tomorrow morning. I think the professor and I had better retire and leave you gentlemen to your pleasures. Professor may share my room if he so desires.
I'd be only too glad to, Captain Marla. If I may have your leave, Colonel?
Please do as you like, Professor. If they want to go, we let them go. After all, it means two left to share this nectar. Close it.
Close it.
Easy, easy. Stop pulling like that. Stop, I told you. Easy, stop pulling.
What's wrong with the dogs?
Maybe they picked up the scent.
You could be right. Maybe they have. We'll see. Let them go.
Oh.
I'll get it. Colonel Spidle speaking.
You must be tired, sir. Don't you want to go to bed?
No. That is, yes. I've been doing some thinking.
I hope I haven't offended you, Professor.
Offend me? How?
Oh, by what I said at dinner. I didn't mean it to be a personal remark.
My dear chap, I'm not offended. You must know how I've stood. All my life, I've preached against putting science at the disposition of the insane.
Let's go, Professor. Bring the radio.
All right. Are you mad? What's that for?
Don't worry, Professor. The rooms are soundproof. I just experimented.
You don't mean you kill a man in cold blood, do you, Strobel?
I can't take a chance. We'd have them after us the instant that we left. I'm sorry, Captain Mahler, but say, look here. It's your life or ours.
Forgive me, Mahler. There's no need for killing. He's no problem now. Satisfied?
Come on, let's go. Get my driver. We must leave at once. Open the door. What are you waiting for? That's an order. Open the door.
Impossible, Oberleutnant. You've got to have written permission.
Ridiculous. Our orders say that we must leave at once, and this should be enough.
Impossible, Oberleutnant. You've got to have permission on paper. Those are my orders, sir.
Open up that door, Private. Right now.
I'm sorry, Oberleutnant, but I can't do it.
Guard! Open up! Your man here refused to obey orders. Command phoned just moments ago with a most urgent request from General Pemsel to see the Major.
At this hour? You must have a special pass to go out, and only the Colonel can issue you that.
Colonel Spidle is in no position to issue any pass right now.
You mean that you had quite a celebration, sir?
Yeah.
Very well. I'll accompany you to the parking area. Bags, sir.
Oh, you see, we left them behind. Probably be back in an hour.
Can you tell me then why the Major needs his bootjack for that hour?
Oh, my bootjack. I can't imagine what I was thinking.
What's this all about at this time of night? What is it? Who are you looking for? What's happened?
Beckham!
If he comes this way, we will get him.
They've been through here.
We thought we saw him, Herr Oberleutnant.
You can at least give me a hand. Why aren't you with the others there? You damn coward. Sell!
Yellow.
Doing here?
Be quiet. Follow me.
How can we find him in this darkness?
We'd better find him. Feldwebel Sindelar is mad as a hornet. Let's try this area over here. Come on.
And this one? He's still breathing.
Then we'd be happy to take him with us.
No, he's too badly wounded. I'm afraid that the right would kill him.
It is quite interesting, the concern you show for him. He's a spy.
He's a spy, but he's also a man. Now, you remember this. Until further orders, I am in command here.
Jawohl, Herr Hauptmann. Then the entire responsibility is left in your hands.
I'll try to remember that, Feldwebel.
Take him to my room, and be careful with him.
Come with me.
We were lucky they didn't have the dogs.
Wait a minute. You still haven't told me what you were doing there.
The bodies were found almost immediately. Jean and Louis were poor grave diggers. What's that, a radio?
Yes.
You better call headquarters.
The message.
Okay. Yeah. Thanks. Goodbye.
Hello. Get me General Taylor immediately.
Yes.
Is it safe here?
Safe enough. You'll have to hide in the barn, though.
If I have to, who else is here?
Just my father.
Is he one of us?
Oh, no. He's very old. He doesn't want to fight anymore. He just wants to enjoy the few years he has, and...
You can't hold that against him.
Oh, I don't. That's just the way he is.
Denise! 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 Is that you?
Yes!
Well, come in right away. Something terrible's happened. The Germans are in a rage.
Dad, don't worry so much. Go back in and lie down.
Lie down, you say? I'd like to know how you'd like it. To be 75 and someday you'll understand. I'll not pay for what they did.
Lieutenant Strubel will maintain constant communications with headquarters. Come over here, Jack. This is it. They here. And these are the aerial photographs that were taken at dawn. You'll jump tonight. Now, Jack, there is one farm which is close to your landing area, and it's a friendly one. Lieutenant Strubel made sure of that. Now, this is a copy of your landing map. I want you to learn that by heart. Your takeoff time is 1900 hours. All set? I wish you good luck.
Thank you, Major. We'll need it.
Captain Murphy, you don't seem very enthusiastic about this operation.
Should I be?
Good God, man. You'll be the first American soldier to set foot in France.
I've been trying to appreciate that fact for more than a month. I'll be damned if I can. I know it's a blow against the Nazis. We're protecting the free world. Defending the men on the 29th from death by fire. I'm aware of those facts, Major.
Do you really think that's the right attitude to have before taking off on an operation like this?
All right. What's really been hitting me is that this operation is already butchered.
My intelligence. Can you tell me why, once that unit was inside, why they didn't blow that bunker? You know damn well that we haven't got a chance in hell.
It was their job to locate the bunker, and it's your job to blow it. You can do it, Jack. We have it worked out to the last detail.
You know what they call this operation?
Operation Gambit.
You know what that means? It's a chess move. You sacrifice one piece to protect another. That is a gambit.
Sergeant Wagner. We have to keep him happy.
Yes, but don't overdo it. You know how these Germans are. They'll eat us out of house and home if you give them half a chance. But you're right. I don't want any trouble.
Now for some special messages. The medals are green. We grow too soon old and too late.
Denise, turn that radio off. You know it's forbidden to listen to an enemy program. I've told you before. Now, why do you do it?
Honestly, you worry too much.
Well, someone has to worry around here. Now, what's the matter with you? Don't you realize that there's a military ban on that broadcast?
Denise,
turn it off.
Charles has a new...
There, it's off. Are you satisfied?
Where are you going?
To take this to Sergeant Wagner.
Einen Augenblick. 420. Keine Verbindung kann hergestellt werden. Einen Augenblick.
Know what the message?
No, Major.
Connect me with General Pemsel. Hello? Oh, it's your bag. What's that you say? They've just transmitted the first verse of Verlaine.
A moment ago, sir, reports indicate that the second verse will be transmitted within 24 hours, and I don't have to tell you, General, what that holds in store for us.
The invasion, according to a great many generals. We must transmit every bit of information to headquarters, Baring.
But what about local army units? Hadn't we better advise them, sir?
Just do your job, Major Baring, and leave the decisions to me. And for your information, the opinions of generals at headquarters are not always right.
So it's finally happening. The invasion of Normandy, Lieutenant. That means they'll be sending the paratroopers in tonight. Do you know exactly where they're going to land?
They'll inform me by radio in about 2 hours.
Then we'll be on hand to greet them just as soon as they land.
We? Oui. No, no. No women allowed.
What is it?
Oh, 1,000 excuses, Lieutenant. After all, I didn't know. She never said a thing. That naughty little Denise, not a thing.
You object? Perhaps you don't like Germans?
Oh, on the contrary, Lieutenant. I consider it a great honor.
Then get out of here and don't bother me.
Just as you say.
Just like a line from a play, but you were on the stage.
I was in a play at school once.
Well, honey, this is dress rehearsal.
Lieutenant.
just about there. You better prepare to jump. Why aren't they jumping?
Captain.
Shut up, Doss.
They'll play hearts all the way home.
I'm missing 5 men and equipment. That mean anything to you, Doss?
Not to me.
Doesn't mean anything to me either. We've heard it. I can tell you what happened. Don't shoot, Captain Murphy. I'm an American officer. Stop and listen to me. This uniform is only my cupboard. I've got news for you. The Supreme Command has put off the start of D-Day. And for you, I'm afraid the news was sent late. And you busted my radio.
Yeah. D-Day's been postponed. And we're here behind German lines alone and without any equipment. All we can do is wait until the invasion starts.
Who says we should believe Pretty Boy? Why did we do all that training that we did? I came here to kill me some Germans.
Make sure you leave a few for the invading force, Doss. That is, if there's going to be one. Meantime, we're in a hell of a mess.
I've come to help.
I'm not so sure. On the devil, men. All right. Check him out, Doss.
Who are the National League champions?
The Giants.
And the leading batter?
Ted Warren.
Where's Newark?
New Jersey.
In Newark, what's the fine for a double parking ticket?
Hmm? $2.50.
Who's Charlie McCarthy's friend?
Edgar Bergen.
Junior might not be fooling us, Captain.
I'm Lieutenant Strobel to you, Sergeant. Now, let's get going.
Bury your chutes in the woods, men. And don't leave any traces. Come on, let's go.
I'd like to know what the hell is going on up there.
It's just a simple postponement.
But can you tell me why?
The meteorological officer stopped it. It's no one's fault. Were you able to stop the jump in time?
No. No. The message was late by seconds. Murphy and some of his men were already off the plane.
I wonder if we can try and rescue all of those men.
Let's admit that Operation Gambit was doomed to fail before it began. It's a shame it's infeasible. Yet, to order others to go in after them would be suicide.
You're right. But I'm a soft-hearted man, and you know it. I still feel guilty.
This is it. You can trust the cows.
Got a cigarette?
I've seen better hiding places.
All right, men, up in the loft.
Yeah.
We'll all be safe here. I'm sure of that. We left no traces for the Germans to follow.
Well, maybe you're right, but I got a feeling somewhere along the line we followed up.
Why?
I just don't like it.
I think the word for that is pessimism.
Well, I just don't want to die among a bunch of cows.
Good luck. Living amongst them may prove equally undesirable.
What a stink. But then a redneck like you, Harris. I bet you feel right at home. Too bad your sister ain't here. We could have us a little roll in the hay.
I wish you wouldn't talk dirty about my baby sister, Sergeant. You all know what upsets me.
You were brought up in dirt.
Tell me, Sergeant, you got nothing else to do but constantly pick on this man, huh? Now you try and hand me that stuff and you're gonna pay for it.
Listen, Foster. I can take five guys like you. Count it or I'll smash that big nose.
Sure, sure. You might hit it. But then you'd be flat on your back. Embarrassing for you.
All right, knock it off, you two. I don't even want to hear you breathe.
I'll speak to you later.
He turned me down for the part of a German officer. I was the wrong type. Too American.
But why don't you forget about Sandoval and Broadway? What we need is a radio, one that works.
That doesn't make any difference.
What do you mean?
We wouldn't be able to transmit. The Germans would pick us up in a minute. They're experts. Damn it.
We could sure as hell listen. How are we going to know the time for D-Day?
We'll have to leave that up to Denise. She'll pick it up for us.
The cows are restless this morning. Now, why should they be disturbed? Do you have any idea why, Denise?
Message is genuine. I believe the bombardment will commence tomorrow morning. I just hope the general agrees. Get me headquarters, Schnell.
Nothing, Feldwebel.
Nothing, eh? Come down here. And you? You've seen no one?
No one.
Should we have seen anyone?
Silence, Denise.
Who is he?
My daughter.
We've done nothing. So please remove your soldiers and let us alone.
Do as I
happen to find a parachute near the swamp.
Who asked you to offer that information in front of suspects?
Please tell him, Sergeant, that we would never do a thing.
You're a Frenchman! Have the men looked everywhere?
Yes, sir. We found nothing.
Come in here. the dogs found no traces?
Nothing, sir. The way these cows stink, the dogs could smell nothing else.
Your insolence isn't very funny. Alfonso, sit.
Is it safe now?
I think so.
But what were they looking for? Me, could I have anything to do with the parachute? I tell you this, Denise. One day, it'll be the end for me.
But Papa will be liberated soon.
Liberated? Will you quit using words like that? You never know who's listening. How did you get in there? It wasn't my fault. You must let me clean your uniform. Such a good uniform. There it is now. You can always depend on me.
I knew war was hell, but I didn't think I'd end up in a pile of cow shit. You'd better hide those jumpsuits in the straw.
One man in this outfit stupid enough to leave his parachute in the open.
Gee, Sergeant, there ain't no telling who.
Dumb rebel.
And I say the man is innocent. If you say only the dumbest man in the outfit could have fouled up like that, then I say you're the one who left the chute.
You have a big beak, and you're going to have it flattened out for you, Father.
Mm-hmm. Foster, put that knife away.
I said that's enough.
Are you mad? The Germans are close.
I gave you an order.
That means now.
We're not on a dummy run any longer.
Get back into the barn on the double.
But I don't understand.
Worse than a skunk. All right, let's go. Everybody inside the barn.
You know, when I tell my kids what war was really like, do you think they're going to believe me?
Oh, this is nothing. We'll probably land in the sewer next time.
And my daddy always said cow dung was good for the asthma.
They should 2 minutes. Look out.
Foster, over there. And you, Wells, take the window.
I'm sorry, Captain, but it was the only way to keep the dogs from sniffing you out.
Well, they didn't find us. That's what counts. I don't think anyone minded.
Someone explain. Tell me. Who are all these men?
Don't worry.
We're Archangels of Liberty, Grandpa. Don't smell too good, but you're to blame for that. A little bit of paragraph can do wonders for your cows.
This makes collaborators of us. I'm an enemy of no one, but I can't risk my life and the life of my daughter. You and your men must get out.
Okay, Pop. We'll pull out just as soon as it gets dark.
You'll get what's coming.
Papa!
I mean what I say, Denise. If you want war, have war. But I'll have no part of it. I'm just an old man. Get out of here, understand?
I must say the old boy hasn't shown too much enthusiasm for liberation.
You're young. You have no idea.
He's really a fine man. When he was a boy, he fought
The simple way I look at it, he ain't got any guts.
Shut up, Sergeant. If it weren't for this girl, you wouldn't be alive.
If I am a coward, American, that is my affair. You haven't any right to do this to us. You must go. You must leave us right now, understand?
We'll leave when it's dark, Matsuri. I promise.
Very well, I warned you.
Where are you going, Papa?
Where do you think I'm going? To Usine. I must do it. Someone has got to do it. And what do they care? They'll only be prisoners, but the Germans will shoot us.
No, they won't. I'll save them the trouble.
No, no, you mustn't. He's a harmless old man. No. No.
That's enough, Doug. You can shove your orders. You're out of uniform. Don't tell me.
Put that knife away. Relax and shut up.
If you want me to give this blade up, you'll have to make me.
I said get hold of yourself.
This unit. It's my family. If I have to, I'll even rip his belly to put out.
Now get
listen to your thick skulls. There's only one man in command of this unit, and that's me. I give the orders, you carry them out. As long as I'm alive, that's the way it is. This includes you, Lieutenant.
Yeah, and with that, the little old one found a little old thing with wheels on, and he's taking off.
After him, he mustn't get away.
Go on, shot. You'll have the whole German army out.
Captain, hurry. We can catch him. I know the shortcut.
Get the men back inside and shut the door.
Fall back in the barn.
I told... Wait a minute.
It won't be long before they find those bodies. And that's for sure. We can't stay on at Denise's farm, so we better find ourselves a new place. What do you think?
I'm beginning to think you're a die-hard optimist.
Denise, we have to go now. There's nothing more we can do. I'm sorry. You know that, don't you?
We haven't got enough problems. Now he has to fall in love.
On your face, those orders concern me. Your battle is already finished. Hey, Captain Mahler.
Yes, Professor. I'm to hand you over to the SS.
Then I must impose and beg you for one favor more. More on me, would you?
Your cyanide pills? I found them, and I'm keeping them.
It's my debt.
You're a Nobel Prize winner, Professor Obernay. You have too much to give to the world. It'd be stupid to die like that.
make you happier, I live. Until I'm murdered by your Gestapo.
The fact I'm wearing a German officer's uniform doesn't mean I'm not a human being. I'll make you a deal. I'll give you your pills, but only when I'm absolutely convinced that you're right.
This is far enough. Spread out.
Mama always said don't walk in water. It's bad for the dogs.
Dogs are the name of the game. So they won't smell us.
Nothing. You sure you got that message straight, Denise?
They transmitted the last second verse. Bless mon coeur d'une langueur monotone.
Lady, that doesn't mean a thing to me.
It signifies that the Allies will land tomorrow morning.
If Denise is wrong, we've had it.
But I am not wrong.
Then why don't we hear any planes? Past midnight. You're waiting for the rest of your men. Don't. They aren't coming. The big brass probably think we've been taken prisoner. They won't be dropping any more men here, Captain. It isn't the most strategic position, but we can hold up here until the invasion begins.
You mean that Operation Gambit is out?
Way out.
I guess it is. Unless we want to try it alone. Maybe it's professional pride. But there's nothing worse for an actor. And the blow is first night because of the electricians pulling a strike.
I know, Strobel. You took a hell of a risk getting inside that bunker. You know the layout. We all know the risk the 29th is taking. But you're forgetting one simple thing. Explosives. You say that door is 3 inches thick. Figure it out.
I think I know where we could find explosives. The castle at Husene is full of ammunition.
Hear that? Well, Captain?
On your feet, men. Up and off it. Now, you men have been wanting to see a French castle. French girls. You're gonna get your chance. We have a job to do in the next village. Get your equipment. Ryan, you line them up.
It's not far. Only a few minutes away.
All set, Captain.
You're not coming.
What?
You've done enough. Just listen to me. Now, you know as well as I do what the mission means to the invasion. I'll come back. I promise.
Let's go, Lieutenant.
Next.
ist los? Hast du nie einen Offizier gesehen?
Was? Jawohl, Oberleutnant. Aber wir wollen mit niemandem sprechen.
Klar, Fall.
Natürlich.
Aber ich habe Sie niemals gesehen, Herr Oberleutnant. Wo kommen Sie her?
Let's go.
This is our course. We have 12 355s from the war spite, 9 381s from the Romulus. That's enough to blow a cruiser out of the water.
Except a cruiser's 400 feet long, Commander. And it's a hell of a lot wider.
compared to the dome of that bunker having a diameter of just 9 feet. Damn it, anyway, if we hit it, we deserve to get the croix de guerre.
Hey, my hands are shaking. Give me one good reason why my hands should be shaking.
You're not the only one. There. That should blow a hole in it. Ah, Captain. Well, everything looks all right. And, don't worry about that minefield. Fool me.
Hell, Strobel. You've been through it and back. We'll follow you once we get by the wire.
You think these cans of beans are going to blow that big old door, Captain?
More just like it. Move on.
Come on. And don't drop it, okay?
Almost dawn. It'll be light fairly soon. We could sure use some tanks.
The ambulance has arrived at lookout one.
Yeah.
Jawohl.
Regenschirm. Augenblick. Is the prisoner ready for transport?
Jawohl, Feldwebel.
Very good. Come.
Captain, are we thinking?
Same thing.
They've got to come out again.
Happening now, Baring. I have reports that the partisans are attacking.
It would appear that they were not partisans, Herr General.
You see, sir, one of the attackers was found dead in a U.S. Army uniform. Obviously, General Eisenhower has condemned his men to suicide.
They can't do much harm, only there must be a reason why they suddenly send paratroopers.
Of course, I understand. They want Zaire. Yes, I know the bunker's heavily guarded, but they'll do anything to get to it. You must do your best. In the meantime, I'll send you reinforcements.
Thank you.
Where are you hitting, Blake? Yeah. It's okay.
You'll have to admit it was a spectacular show.
What's trouble?
I believe you can say that we made it. I must say I never thought.
Lieutenant, the war's over here.